Okay, start Talha.
I'm sorry, there was a problem. I will start now. So, hello everyone. My name is Talha Günaydın and welcome to my graduation project presentation, which is understanding the effect of stainless metal surface area on hemodynamics of vessel with two outlets. At the beginning, I would like to begin with some background information. First of all, what is a cerebral aneurysm? Cerebral aneurysms are pathological dilations of an artery, and rupture of a cerebral aneurysm causes severe neurological complications. Even in some cases, it may cause death. There are three different ways to treat a cerebral aneurysm. First one is coiling, clipping, flow diversion, and for extreme cases, both coiling and flow diversion methods are used. In this study, I focus on the flow diversion process. Then what is the flow diversion? The flow diverter stents are used to divert the flow into the main vessel. The blood flow continues to its path rather than entering the cerebral aneurysm cavity. Flow diversion technique is a relatively new technique, and it is more preferred option when compared to coiling or clipping, and it is actually more advantageous. Flow diverter stents are selected by their effective metal surface area or mesh density. Effective metal surface area values of the same flow diverter stent may be different depending on the anatomy of the parent artery and flow diverter's wire configuration. In this study, the change of effective metal surface area value before the deployment and after the deployment was investigated. Also, the effect of effective metal surface area value on the outcome of the treatment was investigated by using computational fluid dynamics. Finally, the effects of two different flow diverter stents on the post-treatment were compared. For this study, a 52-year-old female patient was chosen. This patient had a headache and she was guided to interventional radiology department of Uludağ University. Here on this figure, you can see the skull, front view skull of the patient, and here is the aneurysm. In this, we can see the 3D rendered parent arteries of the patient, and these are the digital subtraction angiography images of the patient, and the aneurysms are located here and here. For this study, two flow diverter stents were chosen. The first one is FRED 4017, which was used in surgery. It has a 64 wire braid configuration. 48 of them has a diameter of 22.5 micrometers, and 16 of them has a diameter of 56 micrometers. The other flow diverter stent was product A. Unlike the other one, it has identical fiber diameters and all are 25 micrometers. And also this flow diverter has an AMSA value of 18.8%. For working fluid, the blood was chosen and it was defined as non-Newtonian Burt-Caroom model with low shear viscosity and high shear viscosity values as shown. It was also defined as laminar flow because the Reynolds number was less than 2300. Now the boundary conditions. To inlet, we defined the Vomersley velocity profile. The outlets were defined as openings with a pressure value of 80 millimeters of mercury. The walls of the artery were defined as rigid walls, although in real life this is not the case. By doing this, we saved a lot of computational time. For further detailed analysis, the aneurysm sac was divided into three pieces, which are identical in volume. Here you can see them, the top one, middle one, and the bottom one. Also, a close look of the Fred 4017 flow diver distant at aneurysm neck is shown on the right. Mesh dependency and time dependency tests were also conducted. For these tests, maximum mean dynamic viscosity difference were investigated, and 27 million element numerical model was chosen because it has the maximum mean dynamic viscosity difference was less than 5% when we compare it to 35 million element model. For time dependency, 0.005 second was chosen as the time step size. Here on the left, you can see the result plane. All the results, such as velocity plots, dynamic viscosity plots, will be on this plane. This plane has also an important feature. It is identical to the digital subtraction angiography image plane. Here on the right, you can take a closer look to the mesh. And here is the flow diverter stent, FRED 4017. Now to the results. As we said, the AMSA value, effective metal surface area value, changes when a stent placed into parent artery due to the geometry. The difference, 7.81%, may not sound too much, but when the parent geometry becomes more curved, this difference will become much higher and it will impact the outcome of the treatment. So the doctors can choose wisely when they are choosing the flow diverter. In this, we see velocity plots and dynamic viscosity plots. On the left side, here we see the digital subtraction angiography images of the cases. This one is the before surgery. First, we're gonna take a look at this. When we see, look at this, the blood flow comes from the bottom, it fills the aneurysm sac, then it leaves, and no stagnation region is formed inside the aneurysm sac. The CFT results shows that where the velocity is high, there is also a low viscosity region forming, which is essential for the treatment. High viscous region is essential. And this one is the right after the flow diverter placement. Well, actually, it is 5 minutes later. Here, blood also comes from the bottom. It fills the aneurysm sac. It tries to leave, but since a flow diverter stent is in place, it traps the blood flow in this area, thus leading to a formation of stagnation region. The CFT analysis also shows the similar results. The blood flow comes from the bottom, but it cannot reach the top of the aneurysm, which leads to a high viscous area at the top of the aneurysm. In this figure, we see CFT results for mean flow diameters, for mean flow properties such as velocity, dynamic viscosity, kinetic energy, and wall shear stress. For these values are mean values to each region, bottom region, mid region, and top region. As you can see, before the surgery, the velocity, the mean velocities are really high, but when a flow diverter stent is introduced to the system, these velocity values drops drastically and leads to a high viscous areas, which is essential for the clot formation and treatment. Here we, in this figure, we can also see the comparison between two flow diverter stents. In this graph, the mean kinetic energy of the blood flow is shown. As you can see, this high kinetic energy, most of this energy is observed by the aneurysm's weakened walls, which may lead to a rupture, and it may cause death. But when a flow diverter is introduced, as you can see, the kinetic energy nearly disappears. The flow diverter absorbs nearly all of it. In this image, we are taking a closer look to a to the stagnation region of digital subtraction on geography image and the high viscous region of the CFD results. When these two volumes are compared, there is only 9% difference in these two volumes, which indicates CFD simulations can provide consistent results of blood flow behavior for the radiologist before the flow diverter stent placement, so that radiologists can choose flow diverter stents accordingly, or they can even decide whether to use flow diverter in the first place, because as you can see, sometimes flow diverters are not enough by themselves. There has to be another surgery for the treatment. Final marks. First of all, I would like to thank WITAC for supporting the work and to Uludağ University School of Medicine Department of Radiology for providing the knowledge and the patient data. And here are my references. Thank you for your attention. And if you have any questions, I would like to answer it.
Okay. Go ahead. Anybody? Questions?
Just one question. How long does it take to simulate this one run?
It takes about one and sometimes 1.5 day.
Yeah, mesh size was really big, so that's what I'm asking. Okay.
Emre, you did all these simulations yourself, right?
Taha, you mean hocam?
Pardon, Emre. Taha, yeah. Senin de adın Emre olsun artık. Taha, you did all these simulations yourself, or this is a joint study?
Yes. Yes, to both. This is a joint study, but I had a lot of help from other people.
But basically, you ran these codes yourself, right? Modeled and so.
Yes.
Okay.
Did you run this one on your computer or at school computer?
School computer.
And how did you connect?
Actually, this work was the outcome of the Bahadur Hoca's project. So I used that workstation.
Actually, hocam, he started, he finished his work at the problem when maybe like a March or maybe February. This work is now under review for the Medical Engineering and Physics Journal right now under review for the last 3 months. We haven't heard from them yet. So he had a chance to run the simulations at the lab when we didn't have this outbreak.
Okay, thank you.
Talha, are those 3D or 2D simulations? Maybe I skip this.
These are 3D simulations. But the velocity plots and dynamic viscosity contours are drawn in 2D.
Okay, how does the viscosity change? So you mean, I think the viscosity that you use is not constant. What's the equation showing the change of dynamic viscosity?
We used a bird curve model. Okay. We defined it is as such. The blood flow has a shear thinning behavior. So as it moves faster, its dynamic viscosity drops.
Okay. And I would suggest you talk about the volume. So you add like less than 10% error in the volumes, right?
No,
stagnation volumes. You talk about stagnation volumes.
Percent difference, yes.
How many percent?
9%.
Okay. Did you compare the shapes as well? Not only the volumes, but the shapes of the two figures?
Yes, actually, we cut the 3D model we prepared from this approximately this area, and we extract this volume from ANSYS, and we compare them to each other.
how? What is the measure that you use to compare these two?
I'm sorry?
How did you compare the shapes? I mean, not the volumes. I'm talking about the shapes. Yani şekil olarak da birbirine benziyorlar mı? Hani mesela biraz fark var da o yüzden sonra. Onu bir kıyaslıyor musunuz?
Evet hocam, biraz yes, there is a bit difference in the shape, but it is mostly due to the configuration of the parent artery. The artery comes from this side and goes from there. There may be, I don't know, this, yes, there are some differences, yes. But since this is the 2D and it looks different, I mean, we are not sure about the exact shape of this.
Okay, so it's really good, by the way. Congratulations. But I would just suggest you can use like dice coefficient to compare the shapes, because once we try to compare the images with the with the predictions, I also actually do the same. I compare the volumes and I also try to compare the shapes using dice coefficients. So this might be added maybe in the future.
Thank you very much, hocam. Dice coefficient, you say, right, Dikan hocam?
Dice coefficients.
Okay. Mm-hmm. We know that.
Okay. Any other questions? Okay. Good work, Talha. Thank you.